And we're going to just dive right into grammar. Let's do this. All right, here we go. Page 7. And I saw that you guys all turned in your homework. Good job with that. One quick thing about your homework. Some of you forgot that on that keyword outline, you can only use 3 keywords for each of the lines on your outline, only 3. Some of you had like 4 and 5 and 6 words. So you want to keep it to just 3. You can use symbols and numbers and abbreviations without counting those. So just remember that, but try not to use more than 3 words on that. Okay. Page 7, we're talking about pronouns. I'm going to move this chair really quick. Suddenly it got busy in here. So that's why I have my little AirPods on today. This is good. Pronouns, you guys know what those are. Pronouns take the place of a noun. So when you're talking about a person and you don't want to keep using their name over and over again because that would be boring to read. So if it's a boy, you would use pronouns like he and him. And then if it's a girl, she and her. So it just, it breaks it up a little bit, makes it a lot easier to read. So it says it refers back to the some person or thing. It could be it for a thing. Recently mentioned and takes the place of that person or thing. There are many types of pronouns, and you're going to see this chart in the middle of your page here, which we're going to talk about in a minute. The personal pronouns take the place of a common and proper nouns. That's like people and their names. The personal pronouns in the table below are organized by number, person, and function. So number means singular or more than one is plural. Right? So you can either have one character that you're talking about or a group of people or a group of animals. The personal pronouns in the table below are organized by number, person, and function. So person just means the, I already read that, huh? Anyway, I think I was down here. Singular or plural. Person means who is speaking. So first person is who is speaking. Who's being spoken to is the second person, or spoken about is third person. And I always refer to the game Minecraft because I think you guys know that Minecraft. You can choose what person you play the game in. If you play it in first person, you just see what you're seeing, your character that your Minecraft guy, whatever he's called. You just see it. But if you're playing in second person mode, then you see his body, right? And you see him turn his head and move around. Okay, here comes Christopher, so I'm gonna let him in. And then third person is if you're talking about somebody completely different. That's what that means. Function means the job or a word is doing in the sentence. So here we've got your chart. We've got singular and plural. You know, singular is one, plural is more than one, and you're gonna read them across this way. Hi, Christopher. We're on page 7 in grammar, okay? There's your persons, first, second, third, and then the functions are here. So it says these pronouns can function as the subject of the sentence. These pronouns can function as the object of the sentence. These pronouns can function as adjectives. These possess, oh, it says possessive pronouns. These possessive pronouns do not function as adjectives. So this is a chart for you to refer back to. Obviously, if you're talking about yourself, you use pronouns I, me, my, or mine. And then if it's second person, you, your, yours. Third person, he, she, it, him, her, it, his, her, its, his, her, it, hers, its. And then plural here. We, us, our, ours. You, your, yours. They, them, their, theirs. Any questions about this chart or anything about pronouns that we just talked about right here? No? Okay. And then you're going to mark these pronouns with a PR. So here's your example of sentence right here. Timmy traveled to town. It was busy with many people. He was scared of them and their noise. Remember, we're talking about mice. This is a story about Timmy the mouse. He's little. And the pronouns, there are several here. Is referring back to the town. So that's not going to, when you're talking about a city or a town, it's not going to be a boy or girl, it's a place. So you say it to refer back to that. He was scared of them and their noise. So he is talking about Timmy. That's one person, that's singular. But he was scared of them. Them is going to refer back to many people because we're talking about the town has many people there and their noise. Same thing. So these are plural pronouns right here, them and their. Okay. Any questions about that example sentence there? Okay. Without pronouns to replace the nouns, this passage sounds strange. So listen to this. Timmy traveled to town. The town was busy with many people. Timmy was scared of the people and the people's noise. So you hear people's a bunch of times in there, and Timmy a bunch of times. So it kind of is hard to read and it's kind of weird. So using pronouns helps things flow better. Switching over to page 8. Two more things we're going to talk about. Capitalization. You guys are good at that. You've been doing this for a while. So we know that first word in the sentence, names, and I. Anytime you have I by itself, it's always capital. So here, when the basket opened, I jumped out. That should be a capital I. And then end mark. Those are easy. Those are just three choices. You've got your period, your exclamation mark, and your question mark. That's it. Did Johnny live in a fancy house? Question mark. We always say it's most of the time it's period in this book, but every once in a while we change it up a little. Page 9, we're just blasting through this because you guys are smart. You know how to do this. This is not your first rodeo. Have you heard that term before? It's a phrase. It's a idiom, I think it's called. This is not your first rodeo, meaning you know the drill. You know what you're doing. You've done this before. All right. Any volunteers to read the sentence on this page? Thank you, Tyler. Go for it.
The basket belonged to a master gardener who lived in northern England. What did he grow?
Good. So it seems a little choppy, I think, but I think that's pretty interesting. The basket belonged to the master gardener. Okay. The vocabulary word is master. Anybody know what master means? Yeah, Tyler, what's master?
Master is like a person who's really good at something, or
Yeah. Like a master ninja. Is that what they're called? Probably not. I always think of like the martial arts when I think of master, but you're right. Somebody who's really good at something or a skilled. Check. Articles, go ahead and write them in for just for a few times and then we'll stop writing them in. But a, an, and the, just to refresh your memory, you can find those by yourself and label those by yourself. There's two of them. And then check. Nouns. Easton, where are the three nouns?
probably basket, right?
Basket is one, yep.
Gardener.
Good.
England.
Good. That's right. Those are the three. Good job. And then Caden, there's only one pronoun. Do you see it in here?
Is it he?
Yes, it is he. PR for pronoun on top of he. Capitals, Christopher.
The
Good. The or the.
England
England.
what?
And what? Good. And the end mark. Back to Tyler on that.
At the end of the sentence where it says grow,
And what should it be?
it should be a period.
Actually, no, they
No,
tricked
wait.
you.
It's a it yeah, it's a question mark.
Yes, it's a question mark because what did he grow? Yeah, it's a question mark.
I have
That
to like
page was
read
pretty
it in
easy.
my head
I
to
know.
get.
Well, like I said earlier, it's usually a period, so we're used to saying period.
Yeah, you
Because
have to read it.
99%.
You have to try and read it like, what did he grow? Or,
Yeah.
ah.
Exactly. All right, that was it. That was easy peasy cheesy. Any questions on this page? Okay. You guys know what to do. Thanks for shaking your head. When I ask if you have any questions, if you don't, just shake your head and then I know. You know what to do. Copy this down later with your nice handwriting using the capitals and the punctuation. And then your homework will be pages 10, 11, and 12. You can do those later. And make sure, just a quick reminder, that someone checks your grammar for you, because I always put the answer key in the Google Classroom, but I want someone to check it for you, and they need to mark on there with a pen, a different colored pen, to show if you made any mistakes. And if you didn't make any mistakes, they can put like a star on there or something, and then I know it's been checked. Don't just turn it in, okay? I want somebody to check it. And then turn it in after it's checked. Okie doke, let's get out the binder. You guys did a keyword outline for pizza and chili. So here we go again. Hungry again. Hungry again. I know it's torture. Hungry. And I'm at a place that has a restaurant, like right on the other side of that wall. So I'm starting to smell lunch food. So I'm extra tortured today, but that's all right. We have each other. We will overcome. You guys did your keyword outline, so go ahead and get that out for pizza and chili. Give me a thumbs up if you did actually practice your keyword outline with someone, a parent. Did you actually read it, like think of a sentence and tell them the sentence? I see those thumbs up. Okay, good. Nice. But we're going to practice that a little bit with me because I want to hear you do it too. So let's see. Do I have the right one out? I think I have the wrong one out. This is the one we did. I think that's the one we did. Okay. I didn't do it because I don't have to. I'm the teacher, so neener, neener. But yours should be full. So I'm going to have you guys take turns doing a few of these. Remember the rules, okay? You have yours in front of you. I'm going to take the share off. You're going to look down, and I'll start with Easton. You're the lucky number one. You're going to look at Roman numeral one. Look at the words you have. I have new, and then a picture of a house, and then bring, and then a star, and recipes. You probably have something like that. Think of a sentence, a complete sentence. Look up at the computer, at me, and say the sentence. You guys remember how we did that last year? So we're going to practice that. So, Easton, whenever you're ready, look at Roman numeral one, think of a sentence, and then look up and tell me the sentence.
All right, so I add extra words into it. I don't just go, oh, new house bringing service.
Exactly. Add extra words so it sounds like a full sentence.
Whenever you go into a new house, you bring new recipes, or I don't know what to say for the star or something. I don't know.
I think a star was
Recipes.
for favorite.
Favorite. Oh, from
Favorite. So
like your
try it
country.
again. Okay, yeah, so that's good. Try it again all together, like the whole sentence. Like look up at me and say it.
Once you go into your new house, you bring your favorite recipes, right?
Good. Yeah, I like it. And then try the next one, which is the regular number one.
So, it's oh.
Okay, you know, and you can look back at the original too if you need to refresh your memory and stuff. Okay, got it. Go.
Italian pizza means pie, and Italian or acid. I don't know. I don't make sense.
You're close. Instead of saying Italian first, say Italy. In Italy, try it that way.
In Italy, you call pizza pie in Italian.
Yeah. Or pizza means pie in Italian. Try that. Try saying it that way.
Italian pizza means pie in Italian. In
In you're
Italian.
close. In Italy.
Oh.
Yeah, you got it. In Italy, pizza means pie in Italian. It sounds
In
weird, huh? You're
Italy,
saying
pizza means pie in Italian.
it. Good. Perfect. Tyler, did you have a question?
Yeah, so were we supposed to rate on the little Roman numeral one? Because I didn't write anything on it.
Yes, that was supposed to be the first sentence. So every sentence,
Oh,
yeah,
so did I
that's
like
okay.
shift my things down?
You probably did,
Because
yeah.
I've got on number one when people move to a new place they bring.
Yeah. So let me show you mine really
Okay.
quick. So number one, it's because we used to do we used to do these a little bit different at the end of the year last year, but this is like going back to the basics. So Roman numeral one is the first sentence of the paragraph.
Oh. Okay, so
And then the rest of them.
I think I have to fix my entire keyword outline, so.
You know what you could do is, because it's an outline, you don't have to worry about erasing it. But what you could do is just move the numbers. Don't move all the words. Just
Okay.
move down, you know what I mean? Move the Roman numeral one down and then one through five. Does that make sense?
Yeah, but I'm still short a sentence, so could I like backtrack
You
up
can. You might
the
have to do that later,
paragraph?
though.
Yeah, I
Yeah,
can do
you
that
might have
later.
to. Yeah, you'll have
I'll
to do
just
that
have to
later, but.
resubmit it.
That's okay. No problem. I don't think I looked at it yet, so but that's a good question. I'm glad you asked me. So Caden, I'm gonna have you go on to let's do number two under Roman numeral one. You can do two and three. Okay. I'm gonna
Okay.
take this off so you can look at yours. And
I'm
whenever
gonna
you're ready,
think.
look up and say the
I'm gonna
sentence.
think.
Okay, yeah, think first.
Okay, I got it.
Okay.
Let's flip it upside down so I don't cheat.
Okay, good.
First, pizza was flatbread, tomatoes, and cheese.
Good. You might need the word with on there,
Oh.
with tomatoes and cheese.
Okay. You want me to do that again?
Yeah, do that one more time. With, yeah.
First, pizza was tomatoes with cheese.
You had it better the first time. I think you said, because this time you forgot the word flatbread.
Oh,
So
yeah.
look, you have first pizza flatbread and then with tomatoes and cheese. Try that one more time.
First, pizza was flatbread with tomatoes and cheese.
Good. Okay, good. Go ahead and try the next one, number three.
A cook made a special pizza for a princess in the 1800s.
Nice. Okay, good. I like it.
Okay.
How about number four and five for Christopher?
What?
Okay, so look at your outline, number four under Roman numeral one. Okay, look at the words you have there next to four. Think of a sentence, like a whole sentence. You're going to add extra words in it in your head. And then look up and tell us the sentence, okay? So don't forget to unmute when you're ready. And you guys, while you're waiting, you can look at yours too and think of your own sentence too. Just practicing in your head.
Italian immigrants made pizzas for to get money in Italy.
Okay, good. Nice. That's a good one. Now go down to number five, the last one on that outline. Do the same thing, okay? Think of a sentence and tell us a sentence.
Now pizza is sold almost everywhere.
Nice. That's true. Good job, Christopher. And then Tyler, did you do the chili outline too?
Yeah, I also did the chili outline.
Okay, so you can just do, I don't know if you have it on Roman numeral one or not, but just do the first two, okay, however it is on yours.
Oh,
Okay, so I want,
the
yeah,
first two sentences. Okay.
the first two sentences, yeah, for chili.
Okay. The best food in the US is the Mexican chili, or the best something like that.
Wait, okay, that was pretty good,
I
but you didn't look up when you said it. I
Okay.
think it's best known foods.
Yeah, it is. Okay.
Okay, so try that one more time, but look up.
One of the best known foods in the US is the Mexican chili.
Perfect, very nice. Okay, and do the
And then
next
for
one.
two, I've got. The first chili made in America was probably made in Texas.
Okay, good. Nice job. I like it. Okay, so I'm glad you guys had a chance to practice that with your parent, because what's happening is you're learning how to trigger your brain to make a complete sentence, and eventually we're going to start writing those sentences down. But this was just practice for orally. So what we're going to do next is put away. Uh-oh, Tyler, you have a question?
Yeah, I just wanted to say, so I'm gonna unsubmit my thing and try to resubmit it within like the next hour after class, but I
Okay.
have to go look and see what I missed and what I can use, because I
Okay,
think
that's okay.
I'm gonna have to use the same sentence but different words for the pizza keyword outline.
Yeah, okay. I understand that. No problem. I know you had it turned in, so I would say it's on time. So that's okay. You can unsubmit it and fix it and turn it in later. The first thing we're going to put away is this yellow page, which was just a picture of what the outline looks like. That's going to go by behind the tab that says model charts and outlines. So let's just put away the yellow page first. It goes behind this tab here, model charts and outlines. So put the yellow page back there. And then the rest of the pages, remember how this year I had you guys get an empty binder or an empty folder to keep your finished stuff in? So put it in that. Did you have a question, Easton?
Which page?
This was page 17. It's yellow. Looks like
17.
this. Page 17. It should be in your stack of stuff that you had in the front pocket.
Oh.
Tyler?
So I never saw that we needed a folder, so
Okay.
can it just be any folder?
Any folder. Just
Okay.
somewhere where you know you got to keep it with your stuff for my class, though. So,
Okay.
for now, if you want to put it behind finished compositions, you can since you don't have it with you.
I think
And
I'm just
later.
gonna put it in my pocket because I still have some things to fix.
Okay, that's a good idea. So then later, when you're done, you could put it in that whatever folder you have. Yeah, because last year our binders were like exploding. Remember that? We were putting too much stuff back in there. So I'm trying to keep that from happening. Kaden, did you have a question?
Yeah, I was gonna say I also didn't know that you're gonna have to get a folder. So can I
Okay.
just put that in finished composite
Yeah.
compositions?
Compositions, you got it. Yes, you can for now, but eventually when you're next time you're at Walmart or wherever, see if your mom can get you an extra binder, and then you can keep everything in that binder that you're done
Okay.
with.
That should be
Yeah.
pretty easy. I spend
Yeah,
most of
then you
my
don't have to
life
worry about
there.
it. Same here. I feel like I'm always there.
Well, it's like the only real store we have here.
Same
So.
here in Tehachapi. That's pretty much all we have. I can relate, Tyler. I can relate. By the way, we didn't do French fries. We're going to skip that story. You probably saw that in there, but you're going to put that away. Sorry, I know I love French fries, but now you're going to go back to your binder to source text tab. Remember that first tab. And you're going to get out week two. And I just saw a note that I'm missing pages, so yay for me. Go ahead and take out week two. And it should go all the way to page 30. Called Asian table, and the last page is page 29 and 30. And once you see week three, check wagon grub, you're going to leave that in there. Okay. You also need a piece of lined paper, so go ahead and get that ready. And give me a thumbs up when you've got week two and one lined paper and your pen or pencil ready. Don't forget to close the rings in your binders. Super important. Okay. I see that. Okay. What am I missing? 3 and 24. Oh, I know what I'm missing. That letter to the editor. We'll talk about that next week anyway. All right. The first thing I want to look at with you is the yellow. There's two yellow pages. Not this one, but this one. Remember this one from last year? This is where we start collecting, writing down all of the dress ups that we use in our writing. Yay, we get to start over. So this is page 27. I want you to get that page out first. Good, Christopher. I see that. And we're just going to start with the first one. Anybody remember back when we started this? What was the first dress up we ever did? Do you remember? No? You've slept since then. Christopher, do you remember?
LY adverbs.
Yay! LY adverbs. Christopher remembers. LY adverb. Oh, that doesn't look very nice. Let's see. ERB. Yes. Those. And that's the one that's kind of handy that it. Oh, go ahead, Easton. Did you have a question?
Can I go to the restroom?
Yes. Yes, you can. Those are the ones that kind of added to the verb. I like that they call it adverb because that helps us remember that. So if you're thinking of, and I'm hungry, so I'm sorry, I'm thinking of like a big juicy cheeseburger. That's all I can think about right now is a big juicy cheeseburger. And I'm going to eat it slowly. Because whenever you're eating something that's so yummy, do you, I mean, I guess it depends if you're starving, you want to eat it fast. But I'm thinking slowly enjoying the juicy cheeseburger. That's a good LY adverb to describe how I'm eating it. So if you're starving and you just want to shove it in your mouth really fast, you might say quickly. I was quickly eating the juicy cheeseburger. You missed it, Easton. I'm hungry, so I'm talking about cheeseburgers now. That's never a good sign. Super hungry. And French fries with salt. I like to do like ranch dressing. You guys do your French fries in ranch sometimes? No, ketchup. Yeah.
Mustard.
Mustard. I'm not a super mustard fan, unless I like mustard on my hot dogs. I do like it there. Not on my fries, though. I like ranch dressing. And some restaurants have like the spicy ranch, like a Chipotle ranch. That's pretty good too. Anyway, enough talk about food. Stop it. Okay. LY adverbs. Let's take a peek because, so we're just going to keep this in our stack here, but I want you to also look for the checklist. This is going to be on page 29. Yay, we're back to checklists. Remember these? Yay, right? We know checklists, Tyler.
Sometimes it's my friend and sometimes it's my enemy.
Well, right now it's your friend because you only have one thing on there. So they slowly become your enemy, but for now we're friends. So that's good. This is about the Asian table. That's the name of the article we're going to read. So you can go ahead and put your name on your checklist. And I'm just going to review this. You guys have seen this a million times, so I'm going to do it kind of quick. But your name and date in the upper left-hand corner, it's always been that way, so nothing new there. The composition is double spaced. I gotta ask you guys, are you typing now or are you still writing? I see you're nodding. Tyler's typing. How about you, Christopher? Are you typing or writing?
Typing.
Okay, Easton?
I'm typing it because it's more convenient and it's like if I mess up, I can just go back and like.
I totally agree with that. Caden, are you typing now?
I'm writing, so.
You're writing. Okay. Are you learning how to type? Are you practicing yet or not yet?
Not necessarily, but
Okay. That's okay. Maybe later, like when we get closer to Christmas time and getting into the new year, maybe you can start talk to your mom about maybe learning how to start typing. You don't have to yet, though. Okay. Go ahead, Caden.
I mean, like last time when we did the other thing for the end of the year, like the
Yeah.
typing, I did that, but also, I was doing it also for my testing. So
Okay.
I know how to type.
Okay, good. So eventually, I do want you to transition to only typing for me. That way, it's better. Okay. And like Easton said, it's so much easier when you got to fix something, it's so much easier. It actually saves you a lot of time. Easton.
Can I show you one of my puppies at the end? I
Oh my
forgot last
goodness,
time.
yes.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. I love puppies. Remind me, okay? I definitely want to see your puppy. Aw.
Last time I
Okay.
forgot.
That's okay. So, name and date, and then double space. So, Caden, don't forget when you're writing on your lined paper to skip lines, okay? And then if you're typing, that's the first thing you do. When you open up your document for like Word, or I really want you to use Google Docs. That's the first thing you do is go to that little symbol that tells you the line spacing and click double space. Then you don't have to worry about it. Some students try to hit return twice to double space, but then if you fix something, it gets really wonky. It's hard to fix it. So the first step when you open up a document is set it to double space. Okay, Caden, did you have a question?
I was gonna say if I when I do typing, when will that necessary or well when will that really be?
Like, when will I require you to type?
Yeah.
I'll give you until Christmas. How about that? And then
Okay.
after Christmas, when we get back after Christmas, you'll start typing everything. Okay, cool. So you got some time. Title centered. Here's your title rule. Remember this one? Title centered and repeats 1 to 3 key words from final sentence. You don't have to highlight those or anything. Just make sure that they're there. So when you make a title, you're going to follow that rule. And then this is the one we ignore. Checklist on top, blah, blah, blah. We don't have to worry about that because you're not turning it in person. It's online. And then one lonely dress-up word, ly adverb, and you have one lonely paragraph. So this is going to be an easy homework assignment. One paragraph, one dress-up. So we're friends. Okay. And then mechanics, this is all the same stuff. Capitalization and marks punctuation, complete sentences. This is the one right here, complete sentences. Does it make sense? The best way to find out is to read it out loud. So I want you to read it to somebody before you turn it in. It could be hopefully your mom or your dad or grandma or somebody at home, but if everybody's busy, read it to your dog or your puppy. Read it to your cat. Read it to the mirror. Read it to the clouds outside. I don't know. Just read it out loud to someone, hopefully, or something. And then the spelling, I'm not super concerned about that, but try your best on spelling. And if you need help with that, you can always check with your parent or online if they let you use Google for that kind of stuff. Okay. So now let's get to the actual article. Which is Asian table. We're still doing our keyword outline each sentence. This is starting out really basic We're not worried about topic clinchers. Remember those? Not yet. They're coming, but not yet. And all the, we used to do outlines with whole ideas, but we're still doing sentence by sentence. So it's still pretty simple, straightforward. But I want to just start by reading it because it's always good whenever you're getting ready to do an outline to know exactly what you're talking about and make sure you absorb in your mind the information. So I'm just going to read it. This is page 21. It's called Asian Table. And I'm just going to read it and then we'll talk about the outline. If you go to an Asian country, you might want to learn some different table manners. For example, in Japan, you must never point your chopsticks at others. Did you know that? Don't point with your chopsticks. Christopher, did you know that? No? For example, in Japan, you must never point your chopsticks. Oh, I already said that. Oddly, it is okay to slurp your noodles. So you might be like, yes. Tyler's and I like, no, that's gross. But I know it's gross in here in the United States, but it's okay in Asian countries.
I
And then
just
it
say
says,
no to it because I hate the sound.
oh, sorry, and I just did that in your ears. That way, this is why you slurp your noodles, okay? That way, the host will know you are enjoying the meal. There you go. So if you make a lot of noises with your mouth, that tells the host, the person having the party, that you're enjoying the meal. And then it says, in China, burping tells the chef that he did a good job. That's real. That's true. I have a sister-in-law and she's from the Philippines and she's been to China and Japan. And if you burp out loud, it's a compliment. Easton.
This makes me want to have food and noodles and everything in the story right now. It sounds
I
so good.
know. I'm hungry too. I know. It's killing me. Oh, I'm super hungry. But yes, you can be loud. Because it's rude in America, right? If you're slurping and burping at the table and stuff like that, your mom would be like, "Caden, stop!" She'd be like, "Cover your mouth," or something, you know. But in hey, see if your mom and dad will take you to China. You can burp all you want, and everybody's happy. Okay, let's go on. However, if you eat everything on your plate, it might show that you didn't get enough and are still hungry. That's interesting. In South Korea, the oldest person at the table must take a bite before anyone else can eat. So what we're learning here is like table manners in Asia. So that would be hard. What if you sat down with your grandpa and your grandpa wants to tell this really long story about when he was a kid and you're sitting there like, take a bite, grandpa, I'm hungry. Let's go, Tyler.
I have a question and a comment. First off, my
Okay.
comment. Imagine you're in one of these countries and your grandpa's the oldest and he's one of those people that talk and don't eat.
That's what I'm thinking. Yeah, it's like you'd have
And
to wait
then
forever.
I wonder if these are requirements in the
I think
countries.
it's more like etiquette. You've probably heard that word before, like etiquette, like how to behave at the table. These is especially for young people who aren't familiar with this. But you know how your mom, when you were little, she would tell you to chew with your mouth closed, that type of thing. Yeah, so it's more like etiquette, how to behave at the table. So I don't think it's required, but you might get kicked out of the restaurant if you don't do these things. I don't know. And Easton, did you want to say something? Go ahead, Easton.
All right, so I have some good news and some bad news. The good news
Okay.
is there's no bad news.
Was quick. All right, thanks for that. Moving on. You're funny. Okay, I'm right here. Also, do not pour your own drink in Korea. Okay, now we're moving on to Korea here. Wait or ask others to do it. That's weird. Okay. In Thailand, another country, you should use chopsticks only when you are eating noodles. When eating sticky rice, it is customary to use your fingers. For most other dishes, use a fork to push your bite into a spoon and then eat from the spoon, not the fork. If you know some local dining customs, you will be a better guest at a table in Asia. Okay, that seems kind of like useless to push it from the fork to the spoon. Why are we transitioning food from one utensil to the other? It seems like that's going to take a while, Tyler.
So you have forks, but you only use the spoons to eat. So making forks is just a waste of money.
That's exactly what I'm thinking.
So why make the forks?
I don't know. That's a great question. All right, let's set up this outline. So we got a spot for your name here, upper right, upper left. And then today's date is 9/10/24. Yeah, I don't understand the point of that one. Skip a line. We're going to call this Asian table and then KWO. Skip a line, Roman numeral one, and then we've got 1 to 11. It's kind of a long paragraph, but the good thing is it's only one paragraph. So 6, 8, 9. Okay, thumbs up when you got that ready. I see that. I see that. Okay, awesome. So, again, just a reminder for Tyler and everybody. I know it seems weird because we did it differently at the end of last year, but Roman numeral one is the topic sentence or the first sentence of the paragraph. So, let's start there. It says, if you go to an Asian country, you might want to learn some different table manners. Well, we already know we're talking about Asia, an Asian country. Maybe I'm going to walk through this first one and then I'm going to have you guys help me with the rest of them. But I'm thinking Asian country. Learn different manners because we're talking about the table. I'm going to circle this A and I'm going to put A here. Country. Did you know that Asia is the continent and then the countries are in Asia? You probably knew that, like Japan, China. What else did we talk about? Korea. Those are all countries. If you go to an Asian country, you might want to learn manners. I'm going to put that Asian country learn manners. And we know we're talking about a table manners. We could put a T here with this to help us to remember table. And if you go to an Asian country, you will learn about different table manners. If you guys have something different in mind to put there, I'm okay if it's different than mine. I just want to kind of start us off. So then now we're looking at sentence number two. So Tyler, look at the second sentence. And you don't have to read it. Just tell us some keywords there. We'll all look at it and think about it with you, but tell us what keywords you think would be best.
Okay, I was thinking Japan and then like a X for a symbol and then
Okay.
chopsticks others. Or
Oh,
maybe
okay.
point chopsticks or something.
Point, yeah, point might be good.
But I was
You
thinking to
could.
get as much words as we can, since never is like an X, we could put a X.
Okay, I like, let's start with Japan. We gotta have that because we gotta know where we're talking about. So in Japan, and then a big X next. Okay. Do you want to do point or.
I think maybe points would actually be better.
I think so too. Yeah, I like that point, and then chopsticks.
Because it says never point chopstick at others, but like, what if the other person was like, okay, well, I can't do this, but I can do this. So.
That's true. What if we drew a little stick figure, or can we remember that you're not pointing it at other people? You like doing a stick figure or no? What do you think, Caden?
Well, I put Japan and then X and then point, but then I drew like little wooden chopsticks.
Oh, and then you did the word others. Okay, that's a good idea. You can do it that way, Tyler.
I mainly don't do stick figures, chopsticks, or whatever, because whenever I do, they don't turn out.
Same.
Because I am
And
not
then
an artist.
later when you look at it, you're like, what is
It's more
that?
confusing than if you just didn't do it.
That's how I feel too, Tyler. I get that. Easton.
I can sort of do it, but I don't get it how people do it with like rice and noodles, 'cause like you have to like it's like you have to almost scoop it, just use a fork.
Oh, I know, especially when you're hungry and you're like trying to eat rice and then you only get like two pieces on there. It's like, I
Yeah.
want more in my mouth.
You don't eat that much with chopsticks because you have to work more
No.
for it.
Maybe that's why it seems like Asian people are smaller. They don't pig out like we do. Anyway, all right, moving on. Easton, how about the next sentence? It starts with oddly. You don't have to read the sentence, but what do you think we could put? Oh, this is going to be easy. It's short. What can we put there for the outline?
Okay, slurp noodles.
Yeah, I like it. We could even put O and a K like that. Slurp noodles. That was easy.
I think I'm gonna put oddly slurp noodles.
Okay, you can do that too. Oh, and oddly is actually a good LY adverb. So, boom, there you go. You could use that. That's a good idea. Next, Caden.
Is it the one that way the host?
Yes.
Okay. I'd probably put host enjoying meal. Or host no enjoying.
I like that better because it almost sounds like the host is the one enjoying, but I
Yeah.
like that. Host, no enjoying. That's good. Okay, Christopher, when you're ready. Next sentence. You're muted if you're talking. I can't hear you. Or maybe he's thinking.
Eat everything.
Wait, I think you're on the wrong one. You're on the one that says, in China, burping tells the chef that he did a good job. That's your sentence.
He's frozen.
Are you having mute problems? Oh. Calm down, Christopher. It's okay. There you go.
Bopping Chef, good.
I like that, but I feel like we need to say China because we just talked about Japan and now we're in a different country. So I think one of the words should be China. What do you think? Could we abbreviate China? Or we could draw a chef's hat for chef. I don't know how to do that, but we could try it.
A chef hat.
You like that? Okay, so let's put China. We got to know it's China.
There's always YouTube tutorials.
Burping. All right, here's my attempt at a chef's hat. No laughing. Oh, I'm making it a fluffy one. It looks like a seashell. It does not look like a chef hat at all. Okay. That's terrible.
Don't worry, mine looks like a soda can.
Easton?
Mine looks like Abraham Lincoln's hat. Sophie.
Yeah, like a big top hat. All right, chef, and then good. All right. Next one, back to Tyler. However, if you eat everything on your plate, it might show that you didn't get enough and are still hungry.
Okay, eat plate, no, everything plate hungry, or everything plate maybe a X and then enough or not
We could
enough.
do a little Pac-Man. I know how to do Pac-Man face for eat. Everything. Okay, say your idea one more time.
I was thinking, everything plate X enough, but like not enough.
Oh, yeah. We could do that. Everything plate, or we could draw a little Pac-Man. Everything plate X enough. Anybody have any other ideas? Caden?
Everything plate hungry, maybe. Or,
Okay.
well, I put eat plate hungry.
Eat plate hungry. That might be hard to remember. Did you have an idea, Easton?
We're making the keyword that one.
Yeah, for that sentence.
Which sentence? Can I see it?
This one. However, if you eat everything on your plate, it might show that you didn't get enough and are still hungry. Oh, maybe we don't need plate. Maybe that's just assumed, right? We could do the eat everything still hungry or show hungry.
Well, we wouldn't really be able to do still every still eat everything still hungry because that's four words.
Well, I used a Pac-Man for eat.
Oh, I just did everything plate X enough, so.
Okay, so you guys put what you think, okay? Whatever makes sense to you. I kind of like. I'm gonna put still hungry, but you guys put what you want for that one. Okay that they're different. All right, and we're gonna pause there. Go ahead and finish that one for number five. And then we're going to work on a little list of LY adverbs just to kind of get your brain in that mode. So your homework is going to be to finish your outline here and write the paragraph. You only have one paragraph, so it should be pretty easy once you get your outline done. Remember how you use those words to make your sentences. But we do need to figure out one spot for an LOY adverb. Okay, so skip a line under 11 and let's just put LY adverbs here. These are just ideas for you. And the first one I think of is oddly because we read that. That might be a good one to use. What are some other LY words that would kind of fit in this story? Tyler, do you have any ideas?
I was just checking to make sure we weren't supposed to write paragraphs last week, correct?
Correct. Last week it was just telling.
Okay.
Yeah, just saying it to your parent. This week we're starting to write. Yep, good question. Oddly, weirdly is a good one. And I'm talking about like when we slurp the noodles. We could say loudly, loudly slurp the noodles. What do you think, Tyler? Did you have another idea?
Softly or quietly.
Yeah. To us, it might sound rude, so maybe rudely. These are just ideas. We're making a list so when you get to write your paragraph, you can look and pick one of these to fit in there. How about when you have to wait for the oldest one to take the first bite? What kind of how would you somethingly wait to for someone to take a bite? Christopher?
Patiently.
Patiently, good one. Is your hand still up, Tyler? Or is it okay, go ahead, Tyler.
Depending who on it, who it is, slowly.
Slowly. Slowly waiting for grandpa to stop talking. Just take a bite already. We're hungry around here. All right.
Relatable.
Right? Because they love to talk. They have so much life to share, right? So they got some good stories. We're going to stop there. Uh-oh, my AirPods just told me they're dying. That's not a good sign. Okay, you're going to finish this outline and write the paragraph. You only have one dress up on your checklist, so the checklist is pretty easy. You got this. Easy peasy cheesy. Don't forget to make a title for it using the title rule. Okay? Any questions about homework? All right. You guys are good. We'll see you next week. Have a good one.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Have a
You're
good day.
welcome. You too. Thank you. Bye, you guys.